Hi, I'm Harit Dilshan. In this video, I'm going to be talking about heap overflowing and stack overflowing. And especially, I'm going to be talking about how to prevent heap overflowing. So, what is a heap? Heap is a region of memory which stores dynamic variables what we create in the some programs. So, when we created these variables, they can access globally. So when we create these variables and after use these variables, first we should clear the allocated spaces from the heap. If we not clear spaces what we allocated, we have to face two types of situations. There are, now we're talking about that. First situation is, if we not clear the spaces what we allocated for the variables, there can be a memory leakage. What I mean in memory leakage, when we not clear the spaces, the space is not available for other processes because it's still using memory the variables, but we can't access this variables. The second one is, we dynamically allocate large number of variables for this heap, in heap. Now we talk how to prevent this heap overflowing. There are many countermeasures to prevent this heap overflowing. One such is adding the guard pages. Other one is adding the canaries. When we use guard pages and canaries, we can stop heap overflowing. These guard pages can reduce some permissions of writing data. Other one is store data randomly in heap. Very efficient way to stop heap overflowing is not store metadata in line. Final one is, developers should not use unsafe libraries for their programs. Now we're talking about Stack Overflow. So what is Stack Overflow? Now we talk about that. So stack is a special region of our process memory, which is used to store variables, parameters of functions and their addresses. What is happen is, when we create local variables and their descriptions, then they are pushed to stack. When the functions running finished, all variables spaces allocated, they are all going to free up automatically. So therefore, user doesn't have to free up stack space manually. Therefore, we call stack is last in first out data structure. So now we talk how this stack overflowing is happening. The main problem is, our computer space, stack space is limited. If some program use more space than stack space, the program will crash and stack overflow is happening. Like those, there are two cases stack overflow can occur. First chance is, if we declare very large size of variables, arrays, 2D arrays and matrix, it can occur stack overflow. Second chance is, some function recursively call itself infinite times. Then going to stack, going to full of local variables of every functions, therefore stack overflow will happen. So those are stack overflowing and heap overflowing. I think you can understand. Thank you. Goodbye.